I'm Rick Osterloh, and I lead the Platforms and Devices team here at Google. Our vision for AI is to create technology that's truly helpful. We're using the world's leading models to transform so many of our products, and Chrome is a great place to see our vision come to life for billions of people. Now let's take a look behind the browser.
So tell us a bit about Chrome.
Well, Chrome is many things. It's a browser, it's a platform, and then super practically, it's where lots of people just go to get stuff done online. When you think about it, the web has completely transformed over the past few decades from this place where we mostly consumed information to a place where we connect, create, collaborate, and just get things done. And I'm super proud of how Chrome has helped drive that evolution, working alongside developers and the broader web community. Our team's focus has always been to make your online experience faster, safer, simpler, and just plain better. With the incredible advancements we're seeing with AI, we now have the tools to do this in new ways we could only dream of before. This is truly the next chapter of Chrome, and it honestly feels like the most exciting one yet.
Chrome's come a long way. How do you see its role today?
To see how far we've come is just incredible. You know, today, Chrome is just so much more than what I used to expect from a browser. It already anticipates my needs. Like when I need to fill out a form or add payment information, Chrome speeds up that whole process. And now we're at another pivotal moment. Supercharging Chrome with AI really takes it to a new level, helping you understand complex information and get things done while keeping you safe on the web. AI is really at its best when it feels seamless, and it's only as good as the context it has. The more context, the more powerful and helpful it becomes. But today, I mean, using it can be pretty clunky. I'm downloading and uploading and endlessly copying and pasting links just to give AI the context it needs. We knew there had to be a better way, because here's the thing. All that context, the page you're reading, the tabs you have open, it's already right there in Chrome. So we're letting the browser do the work, connecting AI with a context it needs to be actually helpful. This is a huge shift in reshaping how we interact with technology, and the browser's at the very heart of it.
So how's Chrome using AI?
AI is redefining Chrome in three key ways. First, we're reimagining what your browser can do for you with Gemini and Chrome. Think of Gemini and Chrome as your browsing assistant. If you're like me, you live in a world of tab chaos. Dozens of tabs for every project, task, and internet rabbit hole. Gemini and Chrome is built to cut through that chaos. It can work across all your open tabs, comparing and summarizing information so you can find what you need really, really fast. And when you're ready to take an action, it can help do that for you too.
Second, we're taking the tools you already love and that are already part of Chrome and making them even more powerful and helpful. For example, we're continuing to improve Chrome's address bar, what we call the Omnibox. We're adding the latest Google search features like AI mode directly into it, so you can ask longer and more complex questions. And because Chrome understands the context of the page, the Omnibox can even suggest relevant follow-ups, so you can dive deeper without leaving the page you're on. It's all about making the Chrome you love even more helpful.
And finally, we're using AI to increase your security against evolving threats, like AI-generated scams and increasingly sophisticated attackers. None of this matters if you're not safe. And I started as a security engineer at Google, so this topic is super important to me. In Chrome, we've always pushed ourselves to advance security since we know that scammers and attackers aren't standing still. With powerful new technologies like AI, there are new risks. So we have to innovate every day to keep the trust we've earned over the years. We also know that AI opens up new important ways for us to improve your safety online, since staying safe shouldn't be something you even have to think about. Ultimately, AI is helping us make Chrome smarter, safer, and more useful than ever. And the cool part is you don't even have to wait long to check all of this out, since we ship a new Chrome every month, and most of what you'll learn about today is rolling out now. Welcome to the next chapter of Chrome.
Tell us about Gemini and Chrome.
Gemini and Chrome is your AI browsing assistant. It helps you make sense of the web and gets things done using the context of what you're already doing in Chrome. So it's become core how I use Chrome these days because I can easily get information I need without switching between tabs. Gemini Chrome is smart, it's easy to use, and it's built right into Chrome. Now, we launched it earlier this year, starting with early access for Google AI subscribers, and we have some exciting news. Starting today, you'll no longer need to subscribe to access Gemini and Chrome. We're rolling it out to Mac and Windows users starting in the US. And since we're talking about bringing Gemini and Chrome to more people, we're also excited to announce that it's going to be available to businesses through Google Workspace with enterprise data guarantees and controls. Another exciting capability we're bringing to Gemini and Chrome is integrations with Google products like Calendar, YouTube, Maps, and more. It can also use the context of multiple pages at once to help me understand the bigger picture and even recall previous pages from my Chrome history to help me pick back up on what I was doing. Now, I could talk forever about the many capabilities, but instead, let's show it to you.
Here's how I use Gemini and Chrome at work. I'm always looking for ways to better manage my time and came across this video about boosting productivity. The site is full of great tips. I'm going to ask for a summary. Oh, this part of the video about focus time looks interesting. Let me jump ahead to that section to learn more. The speaker mentions creating blocks of focus time without having to go to my Google Calendar to manually schedule focus blocks. I can easily ask Gemini and Chrome to do this for me. Create a focus block between 8 to 10 a.m. for half an hour every Monday and Wednesday and an hour every Friday. All right, that's done. Now I can jump to another task, like planning some fun for our upcoming team get-together. I was looking for some inspo about this earlier. I used to hoard my tabs, but now I don't have to because I can easily ask, what were those team building activities I was looking at last week? I have a few options and I need to make a decision. Given Gemini and Chrome can read and reason across open tabs, I can ask, what works for a group of 10 and takes less than 30 minutes? Rather than me flipping back and forth, it can take in the context of all the pages at once. What would have taken me 10 to 20 minutes? Gemini and Chrome did it in a few seconds.
I love hearing what all the base people are using Gemini and Chrome. It gives me new ideas to try out.
Will this work on phones too?
We're bringing the power of Gemini and Chrome to mobile as well to help you research and learn on the go. Just like on desktop, it can help you answer questions about what you're reading. Gemini is already integrated into Android, so you can bring it up on top of any of your apps. We've made Chrome and Gemini work better together by sharing the context of your entire page and not just what you can see on your screen. For iPhone users, coming soon, we're bringing Gemini to the Chrome app to bring you a similar delightful experience.
Matt, come on down.
Hey.
All right, I guess it's my turn.
All right.
Jump right in.
Get more comfy.
All right, one more thing that I'm super excited to tell you about. We're bringing agentic capabilities to Gemini and Chrome. This means that in addition to helping you get things done, it can actually do things for you. So now, Gemini and Chrome can handle those tedious tasks that take up so much of your time.
That sounds cool. Show us how it works.
Absolutely. Let's say I need to put in an order for groceries. Normally, this would mean opening Instacart, searching for items, adding them one by one. Now I can just have Gemini and Chrome pick and order my groceries for me. And it could do this in the background while I focus on something else, like catching up on my emails.
Does it go through with the purchase?
No, it stops right before the final purchase so I can review and make sure everything looks accurate. That said, it's good at following directions. It's not gonna order 100 avocados without me saying so. You see, I'm always aware of what Gemini and Chrome is doing. I can stop the process at any time. This is what intelligent assistance is all about. It's taking on tasks that used to eat up a lot of my time, and it's simplifying them to just a few clicks, and I'm always in the driver's seat.
Tell me what else it can do.
Well, lots of things. So far, I used it to reschedule a delivery when I was on vacation and set the appointment for this haircut. Now, it's still early days for this feature, but from the outset, we've been very intentional about keeping people in charge. As with all Google AI tools, we're committed to building features that protect your personal information and deliver trustworthy experiences. We're eager for trusted testers to try it out, and we're aiming to roll out these agentic capabilities to more people in the future.
And we know developers want to make sure that people get a fast and reliable experience when web agents use their sites. So we're exploring standardized APIs to help optimize existing UIs and functionalities for agents.
Okay, tell me how to use AI mode.
Most people start with a Chrome Omnibox. It has Google Search built in after all, but you can do many other things there too. You can create a new Google Doc, translate a phrase, solve an equation, and so much more.
Something that I'm really excited about is that starting today, the Omnibox becomes even more helpful with AI mode, which is our most powerful AI search yet. And you can get help and suggestions from AI in the same place where you already search. That means that now I can ask longer, more complex questions and keep the conversation going with follow-ups. Let me show you what I mean. Like many new parents, I have found good sleep to be a luxury. So I've decided it's finally time to replace my old mattress. Previously, I would have probably searched for best mattresses and looked through older results. But now I can use AI mode to ask more complex questions that are very specific to my needs. For example, I can type right in the Omnibox, I'm a side sleeper with occasional lower back pain, make a table comparing different mattress types. And with AI mode, I'm getting more tailored responses with helpful links if I want to learn more. I can see my options broken out in this table, highlighting the pros and the cons of the different kinds of mattresses, making it super easy for me to sort through all of this information and make a decision. What's great about AI mode is that I don't have to start over if I have more questions, which I usually do. I can keep exploring and refining with follow-ups like, how long do memory foam mattresses typically last, to help better inform my decision. And I can keep getting help while I'm browsing, too. The Omnibox can actually use the context of the page to inform my next steps with relevant suggestions.
So here's the mattress Yana's thinking about buying. She can click on the Omnibox, which will use the context of the page to suggest follow-up searches that she may not have even thought about yet. Maybe it'll suggest looking up more info on the warranty policy or a comparison between the different models available. When she selects a suggested search, an AI-generated response will open up right alongside the page so she can get answers and even ask additional follow-ups in AI mode, right there without leaving the page. It's an easy way the Omnibox uses the best of Google to bring you tailored help from AI.
Why is online safety so important?
The threats have evolved. Bad actors are now using generative AI to create incredibly convincing scams and phishing attempts. We've started using AI in enhanced protection mode, our most secure option, which is now twice as safe as the standard mode. For example, with scams on the rise, we've been using the Gemini Nano model to identify tech support scams. These are usually fake websites that try to trick you into calling scammers or downloading harmful software. Soon, we'll expand this feature to improve protection against additional scams, like sites threatening you with fake viruses or fake giveaways that impersonate well-known brands. We're also using AI in many other ways. We've recently added warnings to site notifications. Now, with the help of AI, Chrome can tell you when it thinks a notification may be spammy or trying to scam you, and give you the option to view the notification or just unsubscribe right away. Since we've rolled this out, Chrome on Android has definitely reduced distractions for its users, who now receive 3 billion fewer website notifications a day.
Any other security issues you're looking into?
Yes. When it comes to web security, passwords are often the weakest link. That's why we have taken steps with the help of AI in the back end to make them just less of a headache. Very soon, with one click only, Chrome can fix compromised passwords for me. It's like a password agent. It's very simple. But before I show you, I have to admit something. I did something I shouldn't have. I use the same password for a bunch of accounts, which we all do from time to time. Unfortunately, the password for one of my accounts was compromised in a public data breach. When I tried to sign into Coursera, Chrome warns me that my password got hacked. Now, the new inconvenient thing is that it offers to change it for me. I don't have to go to the website, follow a bunch of steps, and change my password. Instead, Chrome goes through the whole process for me. All I have to do is click once, and that's it. I'm done. This functionality is now rolling out to some supported sites. Here's a list of some of our partners who have been testing with us.
What else should people watch out for?
So, you always want to be careful when it comes to granting permissions to the website you visit. In fact, you should probably think twice about giving a site access to, let's say, your location or your camera. It is important that you get asked to make the sensitive decisions. On the other hand, if you're being honest, if you get asked all the time to grant permissions, it's annoying. It breaks your flow, especially if you don't want them. And now Chrome is handling exactly that annoyance. Thanks to AI, Chrome learns your preferences and also takes into account factors like site quality. If it predicts that you are unlikely to grant a specific permission to a specific site, it won't bother you. Instead, it would just show you the request in a quieter, less intrusive way. a small chip in the Omnibox instead of a bigger permission prompt. This means few interruptions and you're still in full control.
So whether it's proactively blocking scams, effortlessly managing your passwords, or simplifying privacy decisions, you know AI in Chrome has your back. It's your most powerful guardian on the web.
From the start, we've always been about making your online experience fast, secure, and easy. And now with AI, we're able to do that better than ever and make Chrome even more helpful.
It all adds up to a single idea, a browser that works for you, one that understands what you need, helps you get things done faster, and keeps you safe online. This isn't just our vision for the future. The next chapter of Chrome is here, and you can experience it by making sure your browser is up to date. We can't wait to hear what you think.
On behalf of the team, thanks for joining us today.